Man, you know that practicing how to speak and write in the language you're learning is important, right? But you don't know where to get ideas from to practice these, innit? I'm gonna solve this problem in this video, so don't switch to another video if you're interested. Like you all already know, I'm Tony. My channel is about languages, cultures, and travel. If you're interested, click on the subscribe button and on the notification bell. So like I said, I'm gonna give you ideas or websites where you can get ideas from to practice output in the language that you're learning. Number one, you gotta use apps like Quora and HelloTalk. What exactly is HelloTalk? On HelloTalk, you get like an online exchange, you know, where you help someone with the language he's learning, and then that person helps you with the language you are learning. And in most cases, you help him in your mother language and he helps you with his mother language. But it doesn't just end here. You can chat through texts, video calls, or audio calls. And then on the other hand, we have Quora, right? Quora is more of like a social network where people ask questions and get answers from people who know the answers to these questions. And it exists in multiple languages, you know, for example, English, French, Chinese, Japanese. I don't really know all the languages it exists in, but I know it exists in several languages. Number two, you gotta read books. Now, I wanna stop you before you start screaming out, Tony, we want to practice how to write and speak, not how to read. I would like to say that you should read the book first and then you summarize the book, you know, either orally or by writing it down in a book or in your laptop or in a diary or so. Number three, reply back. When you're watching a movie or a TV show, let me say on Netflix, then at some point in time, pause the movie and reply back to the characters. Wait a minute. What? Come on, man, be serious. How am I supposed to do that, Tony? Well, it is easy, right? If you're watching a TV show or a movie and then at some point in time it gets really exciting, you're really engaged, or something happens that you find really terrible, pause the movie and then talk about it. Number four, describe your environment. Do you travel a lot? Yes. Then that is great. Wait, you said no? Well, you know, it is great too, you know, it is very important like to stay in at home because, you know, there are sometimes, you know, but there are also, you know what, just let it be. So whenever you're somewhere, for example, stuck in traffic or in your office or you're at a seminar or even in a park, then just take some time, you know, take some time, calm down, relax, slow down, and then describe what is going on around you. You know, if the birds are singing, say the birds are singing. Try to talk about it. Number five, make a diary. You know, at the end of the day, you're tired. I know, believe me, I know. But if you can just take, you know, 4, 5, 10, 15, 20, 30 minutes of your time, and then write down, describe the way you feel, write down what happened during the day in this language you're trying to learn, you know, it will take you to further heights, you know. So just try and do it, discipline yourself and do it every day. Then we have number six, right? We have which is random word generator, right? So just Google this, random word generator. Then you'll get, guess what? A random word generator, exactly. And then use this random word generator to generate a random word. Yeah, I know I'm saying random word many times, you know, but use this random word generator to generate random words and then try to expand on these words, you know. For example, from these random words you get, like, for example, towel. Then try to talk about towels, you know. For example, towels are very soft. I used towel to bathe, you know. So just try to expand on the word in the language you're trying to learn. Man, you know what, guys? I want to thank you for watching, and still, I gotta tell you guys, it is quite tiring to produce all this content for you guys. You guys, really, believe me, but I still keep on doing this. If you don't want to miss any of my future videos, subscribe to my channel. and click on the notification bell so that you will get notified whenever I release a new video. Don't forget to like the video if you found it informative. And I would like to know in the comments below, what are some methods that you use to practice writing and speak, you know, to get ideas on what to write and speak about in the foreign language you're learning. So thank you again for watching. See you in my next video. Peace.